of family life and in the bonds of charity. And so in the joy of your house, delight one day in eternal rewards. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Thank you. By faith he received God to generate, even though he was past the normal age, and Sarah herself was sterile. For he thought that the one who had made the promise was trustworthy. So it was that there came forth from one man, himself as good as dead, descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky, and as countless as the sand on the seashore. By faith, Abraham, when put to the test, offered up Isaac, and he who had received the promise was ready to offer his only son, of whom it was said, through Isaac, descendants shall bear your name. He reasoned that God was able to raise even from the dead, and he received Isaac back as a symbol, the word of the Lord.
She never left the temple, but worshipped night and day with fasting and prayer. And coming forward at that very time, she gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were awaiting the redemption of Jerusalem. When they had fulfilled all the prescriptions of the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The Gospel of the Lord. Happy Feast Day, everyone. Feast of the Holy Family. This is a Holy Family, right? That I'm standing in front of you? I think so. I believe so. And I'm inspired by your holiness. And I mean that most sincerely. When you think about families, they come in all different shapes and sizes. Many of us love to tell stories about some of the characters in our families, and others of us kind of like shy our head when people ask us about our families. But the fact of the matter is, we belong to multiple families, don't we? Certainly our biological family. This is my father's nose. We have our immediate family. We have our extended family. And we share many customs and many wonderful celebrations together. We have the human family, of which we are all part. We certainly have our parish family. We speak of ourselves as a family. When students are coming to the high school to inquire about attending Sacred Heart, we always speak to them about the family of Sacred Heart and the faculty as a family. We also have the family of friends. For those who are members of fire departments and police departments, they often speak about themselves as a family and care for one another as a family, and other jobs too. And some of us are welcomed into other people's families and we're considered relatives. I grew up calling a number of people aunt and uncle, and they weren't aunts and uncles, but they had that family relationship. And I have been invited by a number of young people to be their godfather for confirmation especially. And I'm part of their family. I go to their homes, eat dinner with them. We talk back and forth, not as much as we need to or should, but another sense of family. And families welcome one another. And families say, you have a place here. You belong here. And that's what we try to do as a parish family. So if anyone is a visitor today or here just recently, we hope you find a place here, part of, not external from, but a part of our parish family, our family of faith, the family of the church. It might do us good today to just stop as we continue celebrating Christmas and this wonderful feast of the Holy Family, to consider how we participate in each one of those different families I mentioned, and maybe others. How do we participate? And what's holy about those families that we're part of? And what's holy in me? How does the grace of God get expressed in me? How does the goodness of God make its home in me? How do I bear the image of Jesus the Savior, which brings holiness wherever that presence is? How does that presence reside in me? And that's not a sense of pride. It's actually a sense of humility. The same humility by which God left heaven and took on flesh in Jesus on earth in humanity. humanity. How does the holiness of God live in me? Three words that I think are evident in our scriptures today are faith, fidelity, and fulfillment. Faith is that invitation to a relationship with God. And we see it so clearly, certainly in Jesus, God's Son, in Mary, and in Joseph, and in Anna, the prophetess, and Simeon, and Abraham, and Sarah, and Isaac. Invitation to relationship with God. Unconditional welcome. Unconditional, you belong here. Unconditional, let's do this together. Faith, a relationship we enter into free will, by free will, with God and in God's invitation. We hear in the scriptures, God chose us before we chose God. And so today could be a day of renewal for us in our relationship with God, who calls each of us into a personal, life-giving, loving, forgiving, all-embracing relationship with Him. We look to Mary, we look to Joseph, we certainly look to Abraham and Sarah. We look to Anna and Simeon, all the other greats who gone before us in the faith. And we look at how they were faithful to God. And we know that God's fidelity is always in place when it comes to us. That's why He sent Jesus. He promised a Savior. And God's fidelity sent Jesus to be for us flesh, a baby, and to come to us in the Eucharist. And we ask ourselves again in humility, am I faithful to God always? Are there any areas of my life in which I have been unfaithful? When I look at Mary, not knowing all the impact of having the Son of God be born in her flesh and living her life following Jesus right to the point of the cross, and holding Jesus after crucifixion. Her fidelity to God, she never gave up. She never cursed God. She never said, I can't do this, it's too much for me. And God's fidelity to her heart and her assumption, body and soul, to His heavenly kingdom. Fidelity. Am I faithful to God? And fulfillment. We've done our part, God will do His. His promises will be fulfilled. The Messiah was sent, promised, and fulfilled in Jesus. Eternal life, promised, and fulfilled in Jesus. Just as much as Mary and Joseph fulfilled the dictates of the law and the customs of their Jewish community and ancestors, so too we fulfill our part by coming to Mass each and every week, by remaining faithful in our prayers, in our acts of charity, inspiring one another and being inspired by one another. And God says to us, I will fulfill for you the promises I made to you. And so today, a great day to continue celebrating Christmas, still in the octave, still celebrating that gift of a Messiah, the gift of the child Jesus. And when we accept the Lord into our hearts and our lives and Eucharistically into our flesh, how can we not be anything but holy? And we bring that holiness back home to whatever and to each and every family we belong to. So once again, we take some time today in faith to recommit ourselves to God, to the gift of the Spirit to remain faithful, and to be grateful for the gift of God's fulfillment of His promise to send us a Savior and open up for us the way to eternal life. So once again, happy feast day, Holy Family. Please stand. And as one family, let us profess the faith which keeps us one. I believe in one God.
Thank you.
reconciliation, humbly asking that with the intercession of the Virgin Mother of God and Saint Joseph, you may establish our families firmly in your grace and your peace, through Christ our Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For on the feast of this awesome-filled mystery, though invisible in his own divine nature, he has appeared visibly in ours and begotten before all ages. He has begun to exist in time, and so that, raising up in himself all that was cast down, he might restore unity to all creation and call straight humanity back to the heavenly kingdom. And so, with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Father's Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension to heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Behold Jesus, who makes us and our families holy. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
let us pray. Bring those you refresh with this heavenly sacrament, most merciful Father, to imitate constantly the example of the Holy Family, so that after the trials of this world, we may share their company forever. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Anyone who can help us with the cleanup right after the Mass would very much appreciate it. Gangs, you can sanitize the pews quickly before the next Mass. Just come and get a towel, some sanitizer, and some gloves. Also, please note the bulletin, the office hours for the parish office this week have changed slightly so that we can get caught up with things, but please note the hours are in the bulletin. And on New Year's Eve, we'll have a Mass here at 5 p.m., and on New Year's Day, 8:30 and 11:30. There's a slight mistake in the bulletin. In the special section in blue, it says 8:31. There'll be nobody here at 1, but you. So 1 o'clock is incorrect. It's 8:30 and 11:30 on New Year's Day. All right? Good?
Yep.
Are you happy?
Yes.
Who wouldn't be happy being part of such a holy family like this, huh? The Lord be with you.